money or the wealth as we know it has been the center of pursuit for the humankind since ages. Why? Today, we try to find out the fuss around the $1 trillion industry of investments. Is it really so important to save and invest? What happens if we don't save? Isn't our life already heavy with the burdens of so many responsibilities? Why add the complex exercise of investing to our miseries? Let's find out in this short film today. Thousands of years ago, in ancient India, four main objectives of human pursuit were defined under Purusharthā: Dharma, the righteousness or moral values; Artha, the prosperity or the economic values; Kama, the pleasure, love, psychological values or materialistic pleasure; and Moksha, the liberation and spiritual values. Further, according to Bhagavat Purana, Shukracharya, the sage, mentioned to King Bali that out of the total income you earn, the distribution has to be as follows. One part should be used for dharma, that is dan, punya. Second for yash, public works which bring fame to oneself. The third part should be reinvested for generating more wealth. Fourth, for kam or material enjoyment. And the fifth one is for the help of one's family and friends. So what has changed in the thousands of years? One of the greatest investors of our time, Peter Lynch, says, "Know what you own and know why you own it." He has said this in the parlance, in the relevance of today's investing world. But what is the meaning of money in the modern age? How do we earn money? Let's try to explore further.
People earn money to live happy, fulfilling and healthy life. Everybody has certain skill set and they deploy it over a certain period of time, which generates productivity, and through that productivity some income is earned, and that is how money is made.
To me, money means resource. Money is a means to attain things which you require in life. Money means security. Money means a bigger car. Money means a good holiday or a grand house. Or money means security when I am old, I am retired and I need money. Then that is where money actually comes in picture and provides me with my daily bread.
Money can be utilized for a lot of things, to own certain assets, to gain certain experiences in life, and that's the use of money.
So now we know that money is the product of your skills and time. But what happens if you have less of it?
So living can be defined as how people with less means live, just fulfilling their basic requirements, or living could be defined as something which lavish people live, rich people live. So a lot of adjustments, basically lot of adjustments. For any new purchase, you have to think like 100 times, can you afford it, not afford it, because that affordability hits your present consumption, your future consumption. So if you don't have a cash flow, or you don't have the money line with you, then all your necessities, your needs, your desires needs to be really chalked out and see what you need, what you basically need. And you cannot do things which you want to do or you desire to do. So poverty hits your mental and emotional state.
A very important question and the biggest hindrance for anybody who's earning now is why he or she should invest. Sometimes people think that they are getting some good salaries and they are managing their expenses and they are living happily in their life, Saturday, Sunday, going to some nice restaurant, having a nice takeout, or maybe going for a vacation, small vacation, or out of India, whichever way. So people feel contented in their lifestyle. But I think instead of me answering this question, sometimes the people or the youngsters who have just started earning, they should ask themselves why they should invest. The question is that today they are earning, let's say anybody who's earning 50,000 per month now, and he's able to take care of his expenses. He's spending some money in EMI, in rent, in travel, utilities, internet, iPhone, XYZ things. But what are the savings? The biggest question arises if we remember the age-old story of a grasshopper who never accumulated any food for the coming winter. So we have recently seen a big recession hitting US in 2008-2009, where a large population of high earning people suddenly were rendered jobless. So if tomorrow the same salary does not continue for you, then what will you do? So this is not only about tomorrow. When you extrapolate the same question for 10 years down the line, 20 years down the line, 50 years down the line, then you understand that the longer time period you plan in your life, the more you need to save for it. There will be a time, let's say when you are at 60, 65, 70, 75, where you might not be able to put your skills into use. And you might not be able to give the time to your job. Ultimately, there will not be any productivity from your side, and hence the income will be zero. Then what will sustain you? The corpus, the investment, the savings which you have accumulated in your earning life, which is generally of 25 to 40 years. That is where when you save it, the corpus which becomes in today's term, let's say 5 crore or 10 crore, that will sustain you for another 20, 25, 30 years. It will take care of your expenses when you retire. Because even after you retire, you might want to travel. You might want to go to a fancy holiday, luxurious holiday with your wife. Or you might want to change a car. Or maybe your house becomes in a dilapidated state and you want to rebuild your house, or you want to leave some legacy, something for your grandchildren. All these things, all your dreams, all your sense of security is covered by one single term, which is known as investment.
So when you basically invest your money, whatever additional you make basically gives you a work-free day in your life. So let's say if my income monthly is 50,000 rupees and I get an additional, let's say 10,000 rupees, so I can basically rest for another week because I've already made 10,000 from my investments. For me, investment is a tool to earn more money, because when you are not investing, you are only earning for yourself, by yourself. But when you're investing, your money is working for you 24/7. So that is the concept of investing. And it is a tool which helps you generate a lot of wealth. Basically, people require money for their goals And goals primarily are defined by what age bracket you are into. So when you are into your 30s, your goals could be as easy as buying a new car or going for a exotic travel. But when you come across a life cycle, so when you are at 40, 50, you have kids, so you need to plan for their education, for their marriage. When you are at 50, 55-ish, then retirement also comes a primary goal. So you need to plan for your retirement. And at 70s, your priorities are different, so you could be planning for your grandkids, your legacy, your will and your estates. So for all that, you need to have a timeline, what we call as financial planning, so that you can optimize the time that you have in hand to make your money work for you. So there are two important factors which basically defines the quantum of wealth you will have for any specific goal. The time that you have made money invested, the type of investments that you have undertaken for your goals. So that is the objective why you should be investing, and you should be investing early.
Good income is required to lead a good life. But to have a secure future, you need to convert your good income into good investments. The concept of financial prudence has not at all changed over the thousands of years. But still, we find many people are still hesitant to invest. What stops them to invest? What could be the starting point for a well-set standard of living in our future? Let's explore further.
So people don't invest money because they don't like the uncertainty around it. If you really see, people want certainty, but they do want good returns also. So they live in a certain dichotomy.
Myths about investment, mostly people have a lot of misconceptions. First of all, what they do is that they invest an amount, let's say for example 1 lakh, and then they want to get rich very quickly. They might expect that 1 lakh will become 1 lakh within 6 months, 4 months, or maybe 1 year for that sake. For that, they start putting money in whichever asset class they think is going to grow absurdly very high. Recently, we have seen the fall in Bitcoin. It went up to as high as around 14-15 lakh rupees per coin. And currently, it is at around 2.5 or 2.3 lakhs per Bitcoin. So imagine the state of mind of the people who invested in the Bitcoin at 13-14 lakhs and they are sitting at a loss, the current value of around 2.3 lakhs. So you have to reduce the element of gambling. Gambling is different, risk is different, investment is different, and strategies are different.
Okay, people don't invest money for a lot of reasons. Some could be they don't know about investments, they are not willing to know about the investments, they are scared of investments, they don't like the uncertainty around the investments, and maybe they just don't want to depend on somebody else to make money for them. These are some basic reasons why people abstain from investing. So I would say that they don't understand the beauty of investing. They avoid investments altogether. So gaining knowledge about investments is pretty easy. So for starters, you can begin with reading financial newspapers, business newspapers like Financial Times, Business Standard, Economics Times. They'll give you a basic understanding of what is happening around in the world, and they have some pages which covers what are investments, the basics of investments, how to invest, what are the risks involved in different asset classes. So that kind of a basic understanding you can gain from newspaper magazines. Some certain magazines like Outlook Money, Outlook India cover a good content for starters, for beginners who want to learn about how investments works. You can refer to some basic books like Rich Dad Poor Dad to gain the understanding of how investments works, what works for you, what doesn't work for you. So there's a lot of available material on internet nowadays, so you can Google some stuff on Investopedia, There are some good financial websites like Money Control, Bloomberg, which gives you gyan about investments.
People say the best thing money can buy is financial freedom. Money is a terrible master, but an excellent servant. So, a journey of 1,000 miles must begin with a single step. Start yours from today. Thank you.
बहुत सारा पैसा चाहिए होता है लोगों को अपने गोल्स पूरा करने के लिए. लोगों के गोल्स हो सकते हैं अलॉट. आई वॉन्ट मनी टू बाय न्यू हाउस, लॉट ऑफ कार्स, ओपन लॉट ऑफ बिजनेसेस एंड क्लोथ्स.